And good evening, everybody. You're looking at two very successful coaches tonight, and John Chaney of Temple and Jerry Tarkanian of the University of Nevada at Las Vegas. Tarkanian told me before the game the thing that concerned him most about Temple were their guards.
Well, of course, he has to be concerned about that, but I think the biggest concern is the zone defense. Bring back Harry Litwack. Temple's still playing zone, matching up and confusing opponents, but Temple possesses two excellent guards, one Blackwell, a great penetrator, of course, Howard Evans, a scorer.
Now, I mentioned about the success of the two coaches. John Chaney has won 76 ball games in the last three seasons. Tarkanian, of course, is becoming a legend. He's the winningest active coach in college basketball.
Well, I think people forget what great man-to-man defense Vegas plays. I think that will stand them in good stead this evening late in the game. They'll try and run it. Temple will try to prevent them from running it. But in the end, I think it's that tough man-to-man that Vegas plays that will become a problem for Temple.
I think John Chaney might have taken a page out of the Raftery book of getting ready for a game. Yesterday at the press conference, he said to Tarkanian, "Can't talk to you now, Jerry. I got to get a man on."
Well, he really gets upset, gets involved with his players. That I think that familiarity with his personnel makes Temple a better player. They overachieve, if I may.
All right, will we see a game that's going to be fast-paced up and down the floor?
Well, I think Vegas would like that. Of course, John Chaney, will opportunity break? His concern is to keep Curry in the ballgame. If they start running, he'll get caught behind and foul. They must have Tim Curry on the floor.
Third-ranked Nevada Las Vegas running Rebels against the Owls at Temple. We'll have the opening tip of the starting lineups right after this. To America's basketball showplace, Madison Square Garden here in New York City. And, of course, Madison Square Garden would not be the same unless the starting lineups were provided to the crowd here at the Garden by John Condon.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Madison Square Garden, the world's most famous arena. And welcome to the semifinal round of the Coca-Cola NIT Classic. Here are the starting lineups. At forward for the University of Nevada at Las Vegas, Gerald Patio. For Temple University, Mike Griswick. At forward for the Rebels, Jarvis Basnight. For the Owls, Roman Rebus. At center for the Running Rebels, Armand Gilliam. At center for the Owls, Tim Perry. At center at the guards for Las Vegas, Mark Wade. For Temple, Howard Evans. Banks. And for Temple, Nate Blackwell. And the coach of the Running Rebels, Jerry Tarkanian. And the coach of Temple University, John Chaney.
We're just moments away from the opening tip, Nevada Las Vegas and Temple University, and we'll have that in just a night. Of course, Freddie Banks, Bill, is the guy that we got to watch as far as Vegas is concerned from the outside, the 19-9 range. You got to believe he's going to put up a few.
I don't think he ever looked at the lines before. The impatience that Tarkanian alludes to on occasion is Freddie Banks. I think the timing of the long shot. So it should be fun to watch him let fly.
Ramon Rebus will jump center as you get a look at John Chaney in his fifth season as the head coach at Temple, and he has done an incredible job, as we mentioned, at the top, 76 wins in the last three seasons. That is impressive. Jarvis Basnight will jump center, and he will jump center with Tim Perry of Temple. Tap is controlled by the Owls. This is Rebus. You can see the hulk of number 44, Revis. Blackwell draws Wade. This is Howard Evans.
Back off the floor.
Breeswick now to big night against Villanova to get into the Garden.
Good aggressive man-to-man by Vegas, Howard.
Inside to Revis. Around Gilliam for two.
Gilliam fell asleep. Let the big guy shape up in the three-second lane.
Quickly down the floor as advertised. That was a three-point field goal, I thought.
No, two.
That was a two-point field goal. It's going to be tough.
Gerald Patio can play. Junior college transfer. At a Seminole.
This is Evans. Perry on the turnaround. Good boxing out underneath by Gilliam. He is huge underneath.
Big man, but twice now. And it's a bad mistake. Vegas has let the inside people post up and get the basketball.
Banks and Wade are the guards for Nevada Las Vegas.
See the matchup, and they'll tag Banks a little closer than Wade.
Inside pass denied, almost turned over, and Gilliam on the recovery throws up a brick as Blackwell leads it into the forecourt.
They don't use patience, though. If it's not there, they won't force it.
Three-point field goal for Breeswick.
On cue. They won't force it. Played very well. Nice bounce pass by Wade.
And the rejection, but they're going to call it a foul on Breeswick. 5-2, Temple in front after the three-point field goal by Mike Breeswick.
Did he get back and get up?
Yeah.
But John Chaney was up, and one thing I've been impressed with is just watching them in practice for one day and hearing things over the last few years, how fundamentally sound Temple is. He was upset because they didn't get back and face the basketball.
Here's Freddie Banks, 6'2 and a half senior, grew up in Las Vegas, been in this program since the beginning. When I say since the beginning, a lot of the Las Vegas players are junior college transfers. A couple of them have been redshirted, but Freddie Banks has been there since freshman.
Well, Clark has a quote out that's rather comical. He likes junior college kids because then he doesn't have to get involved in car payments. What a character.
Vegas with that all-court pressure, and now they back it off as Nate Blackwell, outstanding ball player.
Looks like they're looking to run a little trap. Freddie Banks.
Meanwhile, Evans trying to show backdoor. Here's Evans. It's short, but Perry. The tip to Breeswick. And here come the running Rebels in traffic.
Good balance by Temple.
Patio, Wade, Banks. Jarvis Bassnight. And Armin Gilliam. This is Bassnight in the lane on the pump. Free for the jumper is Patio, but we got a whistle and a foul, and this is one of the concerns of John Chaney. Ramon Revis and how long he can stay out of foul trouble.
Now, they run a thing they call Roamer Vegas. They run the baseline with Patio. Temple was matched up 2-3 and didn't exchange on that, couldn't get out. Of course, Revis got caught.
Gilliam on the inbound. And this is Breeswick off the glass. Blackwell with the left hand, a left-handed shooter. Nice move by Blackwell, and the dump to Perry. Pretty, and the counts.
And Gilliam over trying to help. That's where Blackwell is at his best. A lot of head and shoulder faking, good use of the dribble, and a little bit of a bailout pass, as shown here. Here he sets him up coming right. The help, and Perry, who I'm very impressed with from what I've seen last year and, of course, the last couple of days.
Perry in the program shows 6'9", 200. He looks heavier than 200.
And I don't think he looks 6'9".
He looks bigger than 6'9", too. 8-4, Temple, and right back from the running Rebels. Banks in the lane to Gilliam. And Revis has it stripped away, almost reacquired.
Evans
poked away again. Evans just being a pest.
Oh, quick hands. Very involved. Here's the same play to Roamer along the baseline, Patio.
Out of Las Vegas, and the pass is pretty inside to Gilliam. Doesn't go, but a great pass by Wade.
Terrific look, and of course Temple with the slides. You have to look away from the ball. They'll get caught on occasion.
Blackwell draws Wade. Wade with quick hands. Breeswick gets away from Patio, puts up a short jumper.
They've got them shooting quick now. That's not exactly what Temple would like.
I don't think, Bill, as the foul is called, a little hooking foul there on Freddie Banks. I don't think we're going to see the 45-second shot clock expire tonight.
They can shut it off right now. BT Brody can go to sleep. BT, of course, the longtime caretaker of the clock. He won't know who to root for. He's usually very helpful to the Knicks here.
15 fouls for each. Temple and Nevada, Las Vegas. Blackwell takes Wade inside. And Gilliam comes up with a loose ball, but Temple with quick hands. This is Perry, and he is fouled going to the basket. Freddie Banks commits his second.
Perry always seems to know where the basketball is. He's got a good nose for it. Right now, Vegas checked out very well, just an inadvertent fumble of the basketball. And, of course, cost Banks number two.
Tim Perry, a junior. Once upon a time, he thought more of playing the drums than playing basketball. John Cheney's happy he elected the former, or the latter.
As he played down in Freehold, and Jack Cunard, who was involved at Power Memorial, was his coach. He was down, was up at Power under Jack Dunhill when Kareem, or Lou Alcindor, as he was named in those days, was playing.
Soft touch by Perry and a 10-4 Temple lead with 16:30 remaining in the first half. It's the first half of the semifinal doubleheader of the Coca-Cola Classic.
You watch that Temple zone. They're always helping. They're always talking.
The alley-oop, and it doesn't work. Wade's pass a little too high for Patio coming in from the weak side. Blackwell and Wade matching up.
Freddie Banks has to be careful.
Yep. He's got two on him. Evans would love to get Banks right out of the game early in this half. He has three fouls. Has two fouls. Quick hands by Wade as he throws it away from Blackwell. And a timeout is called with 15:58 remaining first half. And Temple's Owls have shot out to a 10-4 lead over the running Rebels of Nevada, Las Vegas. Cheerleaders from Nevada, Las Vegas have ventured from the desert. The desert of plenty, I might add.
You've got to start paying attention to the game.
Yeah, you got to get into it.
And, of course, I think Vegas on offense has to be concerned about their impatience. The matchup zone is confusing. And, of course, Tark, I'm sure, in that television timeout got across the point, hey, let's make the extra pass. Let's get into our second and third set without stroking it.
Blackwell to trigger the inbound. And gets it to Perry. Perry guarded by Bassnight. This is Rivas, who came all the way out. Wade on Blackwell. Banks and Evans matching up. They want to work it inside to Perry. This is Evans in the corner. Breeswick.
Good pressure.
Excellent pressure with
Wade,
seven on the shot clock.
Wade's
six.
A step off.
With three on the shot clock. With two, he may not get it off. If it goes, it counts.
Major goal. That was close to a three-pointer, but they gave him two.
I thought it was a three-pointer. I thought it was beyond the line, but I guess not. 12-4 Temple.
Pretty good recognition by Blackwell. Here's a little pressure. They're going to trap out of the zone.
Temple has run off eight unanswered points, and Bassnight stops the streak. 12-6 Temple. An all-court pressure by the running Rebels, and a steal by Freddie Banks. Here's Patio from three-point range.
Oh, he shot that one from the patio.
Deep. Oh. 12-9, and just that quick. Nevada, Las Vegas right back in it. Not that they were ever out of it, but they have just run off five unanswered points.
Great play by Freddie Banks setting up that goal. Full court man-to-man. They rag the basketball very well. They make you use the clock. Deny the passes to the forward.
You know, Tarkanian recruits kids to go to Nevada, Las Vegas, they better be in shape. Otherwise, don't show up.
They do get down and play. A good front defense by Gilliam in the hole. Last night the same.
Breeswick with a step on Patio. 14-9, Temple.
What did John Cheney say? Third leading scorer in the history of Pennsylvania basketball, Wilt and Golem. Quoting him now. Can't argue with the coach. And Breeswick number three.
Breeswick, a sophomore from Morrisville, Pennsylvania. The inside pass and a beauty to Gilliam. It doesn't go, but a foul on Rivas. That is his second.
Gilliam's got to make a few of those. They've been finding that lob pass. Either the pass has been awry or they've missed converting the basket.
Rivas now with two fouls, and we're going to get a substitution coming off the bench. for Temple. Derek Brantley comes into the ballgame.
As they exchange people, Temple got caught that time. You can see the backside open, the good pass, and unable to convert. Gilliam.
Brantley, a junior from Willingboro, New Jersey. Is Armand Gilliam from Nevada, Las Vegas. 6'9", 230 from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. This is the front end. Had an active summer, played with the U.S. team at the World Championships in Spain.
Wasn't home much at all.
No.
But John Chaney, of course, well known as the Chaney State coach.
Felt a little differently.
Yeah, EY and CHEN, but very successful before he took his Temple program over and did with this what a lot of people thought he couldn't.
Of course, the job he did, you would have thought it was his franchise. An excellent job.
Good post defense. Last night.
Last night with the rejection, the 6'8" junior from L.A.
Jarvis got hit in the face yesterday, missed a pass. They did a number on him, all the Vegas kids. They said, we hope you get your hands up tomorrow. See Wade trying to deny in that passing lane.
Blackwell. Nice soft touch, a little left-handed jump shot, reminding Temple fans of a guy named Rogers. And I underscore the word guy. He was a great player at Temple, Guy Rogers.
Communication is so important. You're right, when you were young, because he was way before me.
Absolutely. Patio and Wade. Inside pass to Gilliam. They're working on Brantley this time.
We saw Curry there too. Temple in the back likes to front that post pass. Little late.
Now they're making him work it up the floor. Somebody's free in the paint. Brantley rejected. Here comes Freddie Banks. 3-on-2 for Las Vegas. Pulls up to the jumper from 3-point range. Doesn't get the roll.
Is that schoolyard? The long jumper crash the glass.
Plus, in the schoolyard, it's steel.
Well, you fill the lane there, and you expect to get a look.
16-11 Temple with 12:49 remaining first half. Howard David and Bill Raftery at Madison Square Garden. First half of the semifinals, the Coca-Cola Classic. Blackwell, he puts it up. Basket did not have counted. Wade commits the foul.
You know, Bill Schwing's hollering in my ear here, how many towels did I eat? And, of course, he's alluding to the Tark. When kids would pass up a wingman, I ate a few towels.
Richard Robinson comes into the game, a 6'10 junior from Granada Hills, California.
And there's the Tark.
Here's Jerry Tarkanian.
They have a manager just to fold those towels. I mean, that's a high-profile program.
I guess there's ice water in that towel.
One's cold, one's dry.
Wade's come out of the game as they go with a bigger lineup now. They shift a little bit.
Joe Patio out just a little bit late.
Breezewick with a three-point field goal, 19-11 Temple. With 12:24 remaining. Graham's in the game also for Las Vegas. It's tapped at the Freddie Banks. Pretty pass inside to Gilliam.
Oh,
it's going to be a field goal.
Count it. A message. Good post up and John Chaney up. I'm positive he's upset at the ability of Vegas to get the ball inside. This is unusual against Temple. A little late, but Timmy letting him know he's alive.
Gary Graham is in the game for Nevada, Las Vegas, number 32. Breezewick from the free throw line, off the mark. Nice rebound by Perry and a foul inside by Gilliam.
I think they may give it to Robinson. I'm not sure, but you saw there. Excellent elevation by Tim Perry.
And you're right, it is Robinson who gets called for the foul. Richard Robinson commits his first.
You saw him gathering his feet without walking. Nice prospect, Tim Perry.
Eldridge Hudson comes in the game now for Nevada Las Vegas from Carson, California. And Patio goes to the sideline. As you look at Tim Perry, as a sophomore, you see his stats. Good shot blocker. We've seen some of the demonstration tonight. Interesting story when John Chaney was recruiting Tim Perry as he makes the free throw. The first time he looked at him, he blocked 14 shots. The second time he looked at him, he blocked 17 shots. I don't think he had to look at him a third time.
Well, when we played, they didn't keep that category. Blocked shots. Only won a game or won a season sometimes.
It was a two-handed set shot then. The Temple Owls lead by 8, 21-13, with 11:55 remaining first half.
So the issue...
You heard Howard and Billy talking about the towels of Jerry Tarkanian. Well, what happens is Tarkanian has two towels in his hands. It dates back to his days at Long Beach State when a manager decided, how do I keep Jerry's mouth wet during a ball game? So what Jerry does is he bites out of the first towel, which is wet. The bottom towel is dry, and it's used only for putting it on the floor so that Jerry doesn't get the wet towel dirty. And during the course of the game, you'll see Tarkanian biting on that towel. It keeps his mouth nice and wet. He can yell at his players a lot better that way. Back to you guys.
You know, I found a lot easier way of keeping my mouth wet after the game.
What happens if he bites on the wrong towel and he goes for the dry one first?
It's worked.
Here's Gilliam with the left hand and a beauty.
He wasn't shooting too well with the right.
Yeah. Nevada, Las Vegas, now 6 of 12 from the outside. They're 1 for 3 in the three-point area. Temple now 7 of 14 from the floor, 2 for 3 with three-pointers.
Gary Graham continuing the good pressure on the ball.
Here's Brantley over the top. It is volleyball time. Of course, Graham is the best defensive player of Nevada Las Vegas team. Blackwell with a pretty left-handed shot.
Derek Brantley should get an assist. He worked hard against those towers of Vegas. Tip the pack out.
Graham, an excellent defensive player. Won't shoot too much. Inside to Robinson. Robinson on the turnaround. He comes up short, but gets his own rebound, and he's fouled on the way up.
In the back there, was it Brantley? Looks like they got Blackwell.
Thus far, Nevada Las Vegas with 5 team fouls. And Temple has 4 team fouls. Richard Robinson.
Richard Robinson.
Substitution into the game for Temple. Darren Pearsall comes in for Mike Friesland. Pearsall started in the opening round game of the Coca-Cola Classic against Virginia for Temple. Brantley started against Villanova, now Vreeswijk starting at that fifth spot. Robinson didn't touch the iron on the free throw.
Somebody moved the backboard on him.
And didn't tell him.
Now he's in trouble with that Temple crowd under the basket.
Good comeback. Well, he atoned. He went from one extreme to the other. 23-16 Temple with 10:50 remaining first half. All court pressure applied by the running Rebels. Blackwell draws Graham. Evans, who's shooting very well in practice, hasn't put up much here. Here's a turnover. Gilliam on the intercept, but he took one step too many.
And Robinson with a great post defense caused the turnover initially. Love the way Vegas plays man-to-man.
I kidded Tarkanian before the game. I said, Jerry, you're going to come out in the zone, right? He said, no, we play man-to-man. I said, I know. He was so intense, he didn't realize I was kidding him. And a foul call. I believe it's going to go on
Eldridge Hudson. Hud.
Yeah. He's got that on his warm-up jacket, L. Hud.
He's a lefty, and he portrayed Nate Blackwell yesterday in the simulated Temple offense, and he loved being a guard.
Yeah, non-shooting foul. Las Vegas now at the limit with 16 fouls. Temple is 4. This is Pearsall.
Thanks for a long time with the 2.
Now Blackwell draws Graham. Nice move by Nate Blackwell. Good hang time. And Evans with the corner jumper.
Don't you love that? Good use of the dribble. John Chaney calls it transporting the ball properly. Good penetration and the kickoff.
Graham all alone. They give him that jumper. And that's why. Here's Evans now in transition. A 3-on-2. Blackwell with a nice fake. Here's Evans again. 2 for 2.
Boy, do they compliment one another so well. Of course, they didn't have a break. Lanes were filled defensively. Pulled it up. Little dribble and the kick again.
11-point lead for Temple and a bit of a surprise. Nevada Las Vegas ranked 3rd in the nation. Pretty inside pass. Gilliam just catches a piece of the iron. Robinson has it stripped away.
Tim Perry was out there, and Armand Gilliam is struggling with his shot release.
Mark Wade comes back into the game for Jerry Tarkanian's Nevada Las Vegas team, and Freddie Banks sits down. He has two personal fouls.
Temple doesn't play the inbounder on that.
Well,
out of bounds.
Give the shot to Graham. He's not going to take the long jumper. Here's Wade now. Taking their best shooter in the backcourt. Banks out of the game.
Nice
pretty backdoor.
Bad pass, but nice look.
Good defense by Temple's Owls with 9:06 remaining in the half. And Temple in front, 27-16. Blackwell getting a little bit of contact from Graham.
So Skillion with that turnover only had 17 assists all of last year.
And pass by Pearsall. It's intercepted by Robinson. Graham coming to the left side. Now finds Wade. Here's Hudson. Graham with the baseline move.
Good use of the pivot foot there.
Wade had the shot on the lane, but gives to Graham, and he cans the jumper from the corner.
Once you get into that 3-second lane, you create havoc for the defense. They don't know where to go.
27-18, Temple, with 8:12 remaining until the end of the first half, and a whistle away from the basketball, and I believe it's going to be a foul against Nevada Las Vegas.
The way Hudson's going, it might be him.
Eldridge Hudson gets called for the foul as Jarvis Bassnight comes back into the game, number 44. Jerry Tarkanian using a lot of people. Robinson goes back down now.
They're deep. And, of course, Freddie Banks is essential for this club, so he's either resting him or the combination of making sure he doesn't get that third foul.
Coming back into the ball game for Nevada Las Vegas, Gerald Patio.
I'm checking with Harry Robinson here on Temple's turnovers. They have four. Don't forget, last year they led the country with only 9.7 a game. So one of the things that John Chaney concerns himself with is protecting and valuing the basketball.
Sean Johnson has just come into the ballgame, number 34 for Temple. Free throw is missed. And the rebound to Nevada Las Vegas.
Temple stifled a lot of the running of the Rebels. Good control by balancing the
Graham
floor.
On the inside pass is almost stuffed away. This is going to go over to Nevada Las Vegas as it comes towards our table. With 7:53 remaining, first half, Temple's Owls have dictated the pace. They lead it by 9. This man has failed to win 20 games only one time since he's been in Nevada Las Vegas. Jerry Tarkanian, 33-5 last year.
He's got one of my scalps there as you look at the lines.
Now
one.
The red line is the three-point field goal in college, and the blue line, which is 19-9, by the way, and the blue line is the three-point field goal in the NBA, which is what, about 23-9? Well, how do you feel about this? And there's been a lot of controversy.
I think it's going to change the game early in the year where people are looking to get their feet set. And right here you can see, I guess that's Gary Graham with that long jumper. That looked like close to, I think it's a simple shot for good shooters. But what happens if you start forcing or looking for it all the time, you forget your offense. And you really got to, in basketball, get the ball in deep to be a winner.
Patio to the hoop and Gilliam with the follow. After each timeout thus far, and Nevada Las Vegas is coming out strong after the timeout. So whatever Tarkini is telling them, they're reacting very quickly.
And of course, Patio on the floor didn't help.
No,
he's
exactly.
A fine player. He's been out a long time.
Freddie Banks is back in the game for the Running Rebels. There's 7:23 remaining in the first half. Temple leads by 7.
Now, this is hard work defensively.
Perry has it deflected.
Jarvis.
Jarvis got a piece of it. Jarvis Bassnight, but he also got a piece of his hand. He didn't think so.
Well, he was lazy defensively. Anytime you see a post player get an easy pass by shaping up without a defender forcing it, that's laziness.
You have three Big Ten officials here tonight. Sam Licklider, Tom Rucker, and Ted Hillary. Big Ten, reputedly, each year in and year out, a tough physical kind of conference. You think that affects the officials based on what they're used to seeing? They'll permit certain things that maybe other officials wouldn't.
I would agree ordinarily, but I think they're moving around the country so much more that they adjust to the game a little bit.
What I meant, of course, was the physical play. They'll allow more physical play than maybe, say, another conference would, because they see so much of it in the Big Ten.
All right.
And a foul is going to go against Patio.
Well, right now, I think Temple would not like to have it physical.
Yeah.
Vegas would.
Temple still has only 14 fouls, and Nevada Las Vegas is over the limit. And Pearsall will go to the free throw line. Darren Pearsall, a sophomore from Chester, Pennsylvania. Here's the foul.
You see Patio trying to get the legs to D. Now, they do some drills that really stretch those legs. You'd be unable to perform any of the drills that Vegas uses, but the hand reaching in caused the foul.
Free throw is missed. Temple having some problems from the line. I would love, when I was playing, to have that 19-9 three-point opportunity.
Well, you
don't have to run there.
You wouldn't mix it up anyhow.
Absolutely not.
See the roamer on the baseline. Patio.
Here's Patio with room, and he throws up an air ball, and Blackwell comes down with it. It has been Temple's kind of game thus far, and they lead it by 7 with 6:39 remaining until halftime. Last touched, I believe, by Patio, and it will be Temple ball as Mike Vreeswijk comes back into the game and Pearsall goes out.
Say, if the Tar gets after his club at the half, he shouldn't say anything to the 1, 2, and 3 people. The point guard, the scoring guard, and the small forward. They're denying and they're aggressive. Inside, they're soft. They're permitting the post up.
Evans and Blackwell in the backcourt. Vreeswijk, Perry, and Sean Johnson, a sophomore who's in the ball game. Nevada Las Vegas going with Banks, Patio, Wade, Gilliam, and Fastnight.
Nice.
Pretty pass inside, and it doesn't fall. And Gilliam, I thought, touched the ball.
He must not have, though. He must have taken his hands back. You're right.
Obviously, because Ted Hillary, the referee, was standing right there on the spot.
Of course, here the dribble right up Vegas' alley. Evans with a bailout. This should go down, but doesn't. Oh, he did get a piece.
Meanwhile, Banks misses the long-range jumper, and Vreeswijk commits the personal foul. 2 fouls on Mike Vreeswijk. Perry leading Temple with 7 points. Gilliam has 8. As Brantley comes into the game and Sean Johnson goes out, there's Brantley there, 24.
See how they face? Nobody taking the inbound. Remember the old days you throw it off right. The back of the man, catch it and put it in? Big Tarkin pass out if his players did it.
Bad pass and then the interception by Perry. Vreeswijk right away with 3-point opportunity.
Is he confident? Getting the feet set early.
Vreeswijk now has hit 3 three-point field goals. He has 11 points. Banks with the dish to Gilliam.
Beautiful.
The basket counts and a foul.
Now, Freddie Banks could have banked that one. He was open but found a better recipient in the 3-second lane.
John Cheney in his fifth year at Temple University, a record of 92-30, 76-17 in his last 3 years. And right now, his Owls lead the running Rebels of Nevada Las Vegas by 8 points. We'll be right back. You're watching a couple of teams here tonight that are playing probably two of the toughest schedules in America. Temple plays like the 35th hardest schedule in America, and Nevada Las Vegas is the 18th toughest schedule in the United States.
Well, the last few years, the Atlantic 10 has been looking for some identity, and of course, John Cheney has gotten his club into the NCAAs. They feel they have a family atmosphere, and if you watch them at practice and the way they talk with one another, it's conducive to a lot of harmony and a lot of spirit. And of course, the Tark, knowing the kids that have graduated from his program over the years, the same feeling exists in a different way. It's more up-tempo, more cool, more aloof, I guess you'd say, but the same type of feeling. And alongside there, Jimmy Maloney, right?
Jimmy Maloney, the assistant coach at Temple. John Cheney was kidding yesterday at the press conference with Tarkanian. As Gilliam makes the free throw after to culminate a three-point play. It's now a 7-point game, Temple in front. Maloney is a very good friend of Tarkanian's. And Cheney says, I don't care that they're friends. I just don't want to see Nevada Las Vegas showing up on my phone bill. He's going to talk to him. Let him call collect.
was last night making that free throw. He had pretty good hands to catch that pass by Freddie Banks.
Jumper missed by Evans. Oh, great hang time by Perry. It goes out though off Temple, and it will be Nevada Las Vegas ball.
They've been able to run a triple post on the foul line. That's three players together. One of them is the guard, Evans. And he can come out or go to the corner, and he's been able to get that corner jump shot out of it.
Tip my hat to the folks in Las Vegas. Another nice pass by Banks. I'll tell you why I tip my hat to him.
Look at this.
Here's the alley-oop, but it was a little bit too high and too far away, and Blackwell comes down with it.
They really had him. That's about three they've had a miscue on.
First two games of the NIT in this preseason tournament, Nevada Las Vegas had an average of 15,000 a night for the two games they played at home. Goes off Brantley, a smart play by Gilliam.
Frieswick wanted the foul, but going to the well, patio, very aggressive, really challenging. First a deflection out of bounds, and real smart play, doing it all over the country.
Of course, when they had 15,000 tonight in Nevada, Las Vegas, the NIT committee said, that's great.
Keep it up.
Little receipts.
Ooh, bad shot.
Last touch by Brantley. He doesn't believe it, but referee right on top of the play. Ted Rucker.
This baseline shot. See the backs to the basketball. All five people looking out.
Took me to do it as kids, though. You were closer to the end line.
That's
you
right.
Can't throw
dangerous.
It off your back now. Temple leads by 7 with 4:18 remaining until halftime. Freddie Banks has not been much of an offensive weapon thus far, but Patio just hands a three-pointer.
He's a nice player.
That makes it a four-point game.
Very athletic looking as well.
Ranked third in America, the running Rebels of Nevada, Las Vegas, year in and year out. Tarkanian produces a top-flight NCAA tournament team. Evans from three-point range, it doesn't go, but Griedwick with a good rebound. It'll be a two-shot foul.
But he's playing some half. It wasn't a fluke at Villanova. He's trying to prove it to everybody. Good rebounding that time.
Followed by James Bassnight.
Griedwick has six rebounds thus far for John Chaney's Owls. Kidding with John before the game, I said, you know, I've been reading lately about what the syndication rights to the reruns of the Cosby Show have been going for, because Cosby went to Temple. Chaney, you know, he said, well, did you read about it? I said, yeah, I did. It was like $300,000 a week in this city. You know, Cosby's end is like $80,000 a week. And all because they let him out of the locker room at Temple.
What's John's share?
That of Las Vegas substitution is Eldridge Hudson as Frieswick makes one of two, and it's a five-point Temple lead. Can't let Earl pass. It's still 3:40 remaining. That's Hudson in the corner. This is Freddie Banks.
They've been getting people free.
Banks has 2 points thus far as Bassnight puts up a short jumper.
Did he go after it though?
They do crash the boards. Here's Blackwell. Saw something there, and then we're getting a little bit of a Gilliam and Brantley of pushing and shoving each other. My money is on Gilliam for the Hulk. They're waging a battle underneath, there's no doubt about it.
Good.
Here's Brantley. He wins the battle this time.
He deserved it. He did a great job reclaiming that post position.
7-point lead for Temple University's Owls with 2:55 remaining until halftime. But a good half thus far. Bassnight put it on the floor.
Oh.
Evans said, wait a minute. No. That was not a foul. I know you called it, but it wasn't a foul.
Pretty good hands. You can't put the ball on the floor against this Temple defense. They read, they drop back very well. They help one another out. They play position. Here you'll see, looks like an easy move for the hole for Bassnight. All ball, coach.
Looked like he had McGregor on his hands. I don't know. It's close. Jarvis Bassnight, you can see, is a good free throw shooter.
I'm impressed with Vegas' ability to get the ball where they would like it. It's just that they've either not shot it correctly or missed the pass, or in that case, the dribble stolen.
Lefties, as a rule, are not good free throw shooters. Bassnight is. He's a 90% plus. Bill Russell was not exactly a scrapbook collector of free throw shooting.
Dick Barnett was pretty good.
Barnett was pretty fair. Fast night game.
Dale Goodrich. Not bad.
I'm trying to destroy my theory.
I never heard it before.
I just made it up. 5-point game. Temple in front with 2:40 remaining until halftime.
There's a double high. Double post on each side.
Evans was free for a moment. Blackwell inside to Perry, and Bassnight and Perry get tied up, and Bassnight's going to get called for the personal.
Oh, they're going to call a foul. I thought it was great defense.
I did too.
Oh, I don't blame them.
Second game in the semifinal doubleheader will be Western Kentucky and Memphis State. And that ought to be a tough one. Tell you what, Bill, if this year's four finalists emerge the same way last year's finalists did in this tournament, I think they'll be happy with it. Last year we had Duke and St. John's, Kansas and Louisville. Three of the four went to the final four of the NCAAs.
And Chuck Person's the one that took care of Louis Gonzaga.
Yes, he did. Robinson back in for Nevada, Las Vegas. And Bassnight goes out.
That's a tough call against them.
Bassnight has three personal fouls. Both teams are over the limit with 2.5 minutes remaining until halftime. An uncontested rebound by Gilliam. 34-28, the Owls lead it.
Gilliam, you haven't called that name much on offense.
Nope. Gilliam has 11 points, however. Long-range bomb by Freddie Banks is good for a three-pointer. 34-31 Temple. This is as close as the Battle Las Vegas has been in quite some time since the opening minutes of the game when they were only down two. Now they're down three. Blackwell trying to move it. Pretty
what
loader
shot.
Shades of Johnny Dawkins of Duke of a year ago.
Oh, fell asleep. Perry made up for it, though.
Grantley fighting for the ball, and who's got it? Last touch by Nevada Las Vegas. It will be Temple ball.
Well, you seldom will see a club do that against Temple. Dribble a length of the floor. Tim Perry finally got the wake-up call.
Nevada Las Vegas beat two top 20 ranked teams in the first two rounds. They beat Arizona by 5 and Oklahoma by 9. Oklahoma was ranked 4th until they got beat by the Rebels. A 5-point Temple lead with 1.5 minutes to play until halftime. Breeswick, pretty pass to Brantley.
What post position he has been establishing. Good post passing as well.
Two buckets in a row for the Owls. They open it up to a 7-point lead again. Still very much within range the way Nevada Las Vegas can score points in a by the bushel. Here's Hudson from the free throw line. 5-point game now with 1 minute to go.
It's interesting how in such a simple fashion Vegas will reverse the ball. Maybe will dribble up the middle. Temple normally very good at pinching the ball.
Blackwell trying to take Wade inside, and we're going to get a 5-second violation against the Owls. Blackwell did not penetrate, so it'll be Nevada Las Vegas ball.
Of course, all those rules are out now. It's 5 seconds.
That's right.
Couldn't get anybody free on that pop-out.
So the shot clock is off, and we'll see if Nevada Las Vegas plays for one last one before halftime. But in spite of the fact that the Rebels are not playing all that badly, they're not playing their kind of game, and they're only down 5.
Right. Gilliam, you mentioned, had 11, but he's gotten it on follow-ups. Right. He hasn't been a factor in that offensive scheme.
Freddie Banks has 5 points. That is far below what he can deliver. Freddie had 24 against Oklahoma on Monday night. Now they set it in motion with 10 seconds, and Hudson's going to be called for a travel.
He got the express rolling. He was sprinting as he caught it.
Except the switch track was closed, and now Temple will have 10 seconds before the end of the half to add to their 5-point lead.
Was Hudson a little early at going for the goal as well. 10 seconds, good pressure right now.
Brantley with 5. They want to get it into one of the guards. Blackwell preferably with 2. And it's good at the buzzer. Oh. Nate Blackwell cans the jumper at the buzzer, and the Owls go off leading by the score of 40-33.
Well, Howard, he just knows the game. Once on the shot clock, he knew it was going off. Right now, he knows he has to deliver. Uncanny. And gets a little cuddle from the rim.
So the Temple Owls lead the running Rebels of Nevada, Las Vegas.
Half tip-off in just a moment.
There's nothing wrong with your screen. That's the score. Temple leading Nevada Las Vegas, the third-ranked team in America, 40-33. We welcome you back to Madison Square Garden. I'm Howard David, along with Bill Raftery. Freddie Banks has taken four shots in the first half. He had 25 against Oklahoma.
Well, they're tagging him. Blackwell, in particular, when he's on his side, will go out, stay closer to him. And that's enabled Vegas to turn the corner and get into the middle a little bit. They're not shooting well, and normally when Vegas is not shooting well, you're thinking, well, they're taking bad shots or long shots. I think they're taking, by and large, decent shots, high percentage shots, and not canning them. So I'm sure John Chaney's concerned as he goes into the second half.
Of course, the controversy before the season, the 19 feet, 9-inch, three-point field goal. You see Nate Blackwell, and Vreeswijk has had a big first half from that distance.
Did you notice him drag the foot back, set up? Of course, you know, Howard, you and I figured that Vegas would be the outside team there. Last night with the left hand and Blackwell, see him stop instead of going over the line to make sure he stayed behind. So these players catch on to the rules quickly. And again, that penetration and kick, you saw Blackwell do that. Evans, who can play one or two, that is, there's the penetration in the middle because of the tagging, and that's the deep one by Graham. So we've seen a few of them, and high percentage. They've been open, able to get their feet set. And Gerald Patio, who I'm very impressed with, both offensively and defensively.
Meanwhile, Nate Blackwell, he and Evans, the guard combination for Temple last year at a point. Chaney called them the Blank Brothers because they weren't shooting that well, but they have improved, and Temple leads by seven as we are at halftime of the semifinal game between Temple and Nevada Las Vegas of this preseason NIT. We'll be back in a moment.
Between Temple and Nevada Las Vegas is brought to you in part by AT&T. Whether it's telephones, information, or network systems, long-distance services, or computers, AT&T is the right.
In this semifinal game between Temple and Nevada Las Vegas, he doesn't look too upset. He's up,
no,
down
he's
7 points.
Relaxed.
But look at what he's done winning-wise, 84% winning percentage. Guy's had a pretty tough year early on. He's had to face the 15th-ranked Arizona team. He's had to face the 4th-ranked Sooners of Oklahoma. Billy Tubbs wasn't too thrilled, I'm sure, having to play Nevada Las Vegas early on in the matchup.
Where he consistently wins.
Meanwhile, John Chaney, his team is up by 7, but you know there's a long way to go in this basketball game. It'll be running Rebels ball as we begin the second half. Banks and Wade to the guards. Patio, Gilliam, and Bassnight. Patio misses the jumper, and a good rebound by Perry. Lead to Evans. Evans and Blackwell, the guards for Temple. This is Evans. Pretty move to the basket. Kisses glass and it's home.
And easily done with the dribble. Tark not too happy with that.
He hasn't even moved a muscle, Tarkanian, since this half started just 30 seconds ago.
Looks a little disgusted, doesn't he?
Well, he can't be happy with the way his team's playing as Banks puts up the jumper. He's now 1-for-5 from the floor, and I know that Banks is very disappointed in that performance.
Temple letting them try and beat them from outside.
Temple with a 9-point lead. They have led by as many as 11.
Nice pass.
Pretty pass to Rivas. And a foul is called.
Now, Rivas may have gotten away with that left arm off the basketball. Jarvis Bassnight not too happy with the call, but the shape up and Perry being unselfish. Number four on Bassnight.
Four fouls on Jarvis Bassnight, and Tarkanian immediately goes to the bench.
Once you let the ball in here, Howard, you're dead. Timmy Perry shaping up. Scott Bassnight on his right. Here he tries to recover. Excellent catchable bounce pass.
Couldn't see the left arm from that angle as to whether or not he used it, but
NBA
it worked.
Automatic, right? The other way.
David Willard will come into the ball game now for Nevada Las Vegas for his first appearance. He's a sophomore, 6'10 and a half from San Diego. David Willard in the game, number 40. He replaces Jarvis Bassnight, who goes to the bench with four personal fouls and 4 points in the first half. A 45-33 lead for Temple. That is their biggest lead of the ball game. The Owls have led since the opening whistle. Gilliam on the turnaround. And this is Willard with the rebound. Gets the roll. 10-point game.
And Gilliam shaped up. They got him the basketball. That's where they can be tough. They then can hit the offensive glass because it'll be a softer shot.
Evans and Banks And Breeswick has a step on Patio.
Can the kid shoot? He's hungry, too. I don't mean that in a bad way. He's anxious to get the basketball.
The great players, I'm not saying Breeswick's great, he's a very good player, he's still young. The great players want the ball, particularly at crunch time.
Absolutely.
Patio cans the quarter jumper. That is a three-pointer. 47-38.
Excuse me, Howard. Again, getting it into the thick there, into the three-second area, and kicking out. A lot of good things can happen.
Banks takes a dive. The refs didn't buy it. Blackwell now draws the assignment. Mismatch in size here. Perry takes the new man Willard to the basket. And Gillian with the rebound. Here come the Rebels. Nice lead to Patio. It's just a little bit too far. It's going to be Temple ball, but an excellent lead by Wade to Patio. Just a little too far.
Tried to do a lot of things in a hurry. Got to catch it, lay it up soft. Good look by Wade. Nice looking pass. Just a fumble.
2.5 into the second half. Temple ahead, 47-38. Breeswick has been very valuable for John Cheney thus far in this tournament. Blackwell wanted to go baseline. It was shut off, and he almost cans the jumper. Good hustle by Howard Evans.
Hey, Willard, he's done a nice job since he's been in, but excellent defense on Blackwell. He's got a lot of the old Dick Barnett moves, doesn't he?
Yeah. Combination of Barnett, maybe a little Johnny Dawkins in there. Looking good.
Good footwork inside by Vegas early here on the post defense.
Breeswick. Oh, he had Patio airborne. And there's a battle inside. I think Willard's going to get called for the personal foul on Tim Perry. Perry, staying in shape during the offseason, ran like 3.5 miles a day. And then in the summertime, was playing in the Sunny Hill League in Philadelphia, which for you New York fans that are watching, that's the equivalent to, say, the Rucker League. You get the caliber of basketball that high. 9-point game, Temple in front. Here's Blackwell with a basket. Revis with the rebound.
And, of course, that was set up by the penetration. Dave Willard had to go over and help out left. Rivas all along.
11-point lead for the Temple Owls with 16:40 remaining. Willard took too many steps. Willard right now is at a sink, and Tarkanian saying to himself, I had to get him in there because Bassknight got his fourth foul, and now I'm going to have to get him out because they're at a sink right now, and this man does not like it.
Now Bennett up trying to make some suggestions.
Temple was third ranked coming into tonight. Loose ball, and Perry comes up with it, and right away goes up with it, and almost gets it.
Oh, if that went down, Vegas would be in deep trouble. Perry could have kicked the ball off, and John Cheney, who loves team basketball, just hollered at Tim Perry, pass the ball.
Here's the turnover situation. Not many turnovers for the stage of a ball game. There's 16:24 remaining until the end of the regulation. 49-38 Temple, and right now they are in command. They lead it now by 12. We really didn't expect this kind of a game. You've seen Nevada, Las Vegas at 38 points with 16:24 to go in the second half. Either there's something wrong with the television set or Vegas is just not shooting.
Of course, in the old days, you think they were playing Pete at Princeton. For real, right?
That's right.
But I think it's the movement of the zone defense. They've been running baseline on occasion. That time they did not.
Patio misses the jumper and a good rebound by Perry. He is taking control of the paint. The Owls are opening up a lot of eyes here tonight. Breeswick, who's not shy, puts up the jumper, and Blackwell almost came up with a little Julius Erving move underneath.
Okay, Mike Breeswick is playing like Larry Bird. He wants the basketball. Unafraid.
Right now, the Temple Owls very much in command with 15:57 remaining.
Of course, that's the long jumper. You see Blackwell, something he's done all night, getting into the middle. Here, just couldn't get those legs to get him up high enough.
Temple with their biggest lead of the ball game.
I told her, Susan.
I'm glad you got my tickets.
That should have certainly helped Temple's recruiting.
Yeah. Just kidding, dear. My wife's home watching this on television, and I'm being a wise guy, right? Meanwhile, this man has got to be disconsolate right now, among other adjectives.
The running Rebels have 38 points with 15:57 to go in the second half.
They've been forced by this guy to play a half-court game. And they've got to come up with some different sets because the running or roamer, the guy who runs the baseline, Joe Patio, it hasn't been effective.
Nevada, Las Vegas, from early January to middle February, plays 11 games in that stretch, 8 on the road. Greaswick, jump shot, no good.
Wow!
And Perry, man, is he a factor? He's just looking for space.
Good
here
balance.
Comes Patio, 1-on-4, and he wisely holds it up.
That's what they've been doing. Tempo, once or twice, they've had a problem, but by and large, getting back.
Gilliam, as you mentioned, has not been much of a factor. Patio does can the jumper from three-point range, and it's now a nine-point game. The fourth three-point field goal for Patio.
Little pop-out by Blackwell. Hey, Willard's done a nice job on Tim Perry.
This is Evans. Inside to Perry, around Willard, gets the roll, nice soft touch, 52-41, Owls lead it, 11 points and 10 rebounds for Tim Perry, who's having a nice game. So are the Owls as a team. This guy is having a tough night, Freddie Banks, best move he's made of the night, excellent.
Well, a basketball purist wouldn't want him to get that basket because he actually forced the first one.
Blackwell shadowed by Wade. Greaswick now, who's come back, essentially going with three guards.
Pretty cut.
Good defense by Wade to force it outside. Nice back return pass. Willard with a good rejection, and here comes Gilliam. But the whistle was blown.
Double dribble.
Double dribble is going to be called against Nevada, Las Vegas, and it will be Temple's ball.
Got Chaney.
And Chaney,
he wants Rivers to get up.
Is he animated or what?
Go get the ball.
But Chaney came into the game when he talked to Tarkanian yesterday. He said, I don't know if I want to get into running and gunning or laying and praying.
I read that today, too.
And he's doing a little bit of both, and right now it's working. Temple in front by 9 with 14 minutes to play.
Robinson in for Willard now.
Rivers guarded by Gilliam, who's giving him the baseline and stripped by Wade. Good play by Mark Wade. And Banks in the paint, 2-for-2.
Nice move.
Vegas is going to get back in it, and they are essentially still in the game. They're only down 7. Freddie Banks has got to be the catalyst.
Mm-hmm. He's been quiet, and believe it or not, it's the tag. Watching him when he's in your area by Temple.
Greaswick guarded by Gerald Patio. Blackwell draws Wade most of the game. Blackwell baseline, and we're going to get a foul called on Mark Wade.
Boy, punish him with the dribble, huh?
That's his second.
Blackwell aggressive with the bounce.
Nevada, Las Vegas has 14 fouls, and Temple has not been hit with a personal this half.
That's about the only way you can stop him. I just couldn't get the leg down there. Mark Wade looking for help.
Replacing Mark Wade. Gary Graham's into the game, the best defensive player for the Running Rebels. He comes in, and Mark Wade sits down. Wade has not scored thus far in the game. He is not an offensive type player. More of a good passer, and a very good passer at that. Rivas with the bulk, and he gets hacked over the top by Robinson or Gilliam. I believe it's Robinson. Richard Robinson, who just came in.
That's paying attention to the coach. You want him to become more aggressive.
Followed by Richard
really
Robinson.
Urging him on. Again, each time that it's needed, there's a step up into the 3-second lane by the offense, Temple, and Vegas asleep, particularly in the 4 and 5 spot. Not stopping that shape up.
Ramon Rivas played with the Puerto Rican national team last year in the World Championship games in Spain. 6'10", 260 pounds, and I think the Philadelphia Eagles might like him at left tackle. This guy would like to see his team get more offensive-minded and put some more points down the well.
I always thought he had strong gums watching him mouth that towel over the years.
Patio from the corner. He's hit a couple of those. This time Blackwell with the rebound. 12:55 remaining. Temple in front, 54-45, and they have been consistent, Bill, throughout. They led it 7 by 7 at the half.
Very few second opportunities by Vegas because the guard, long.
Oh, the ball was wet on its way down, I'm sure of it. Rieswick, it's another three-pointer, 57-45. That is his fourth three-pointer. Rieswick has 17 points. Gilliam over Revis. Robinson, the uncontested rebound.
Oh, this should be on Gilliam. He was climbing buildings, and Blackwell got pushed out of bounds, starting to mix it up a little bit.
Nevada, Las Vegas being put to the test by a very solid Temple basketball team. Nevada, Las Vegas obviously favored coming into tonight.
Jimmy Maloney yesterday at the workout was saying, what John Chaney works at are the little things, and they try and do them well. You can see the guards helping out on the rebounds, putting their hands in when the ball's down low. Those are some of the little things.
Rieswick went to the well, one's too off, and here's Freddie Banks trying to get the Rebels running. Pulls up for the three-point try, yes, and it counts. 9-point game. 11:55 remaining. Temple in front, 57-48. And Graham making Blackwell work, bringing it up the floor. A lot of contact. Blackwell had one thing in his mind. Rieswick. Here it is.
Rieswick wanted that one. That should be on Perry.
No question, no question. Perry was using the right hand to stiff arm him and the left hand for the rebound.
And John Chaney with a good substitution because Rieswick right now looking all the time, has to get back in the flow and take good ones.
Jerome Dowdell will come in when we return. Temple, as you see, in front by 9.
College basketball, what it's really all about is the hoopla, the fans, the cheerleaders. Let's see if we can get some of the girls over here. Ladies, what did you guys just do? What kind of cheer was that?
Get everybody peppy.
All right, well, you got to get your team peppy. They're down by 9 points. How are you going to come back?
We're going to come back real well. We always do with the Rebels. Yeah.
All right. I have one quick question. Who's your favorite announcer?
Bill Raftery.
All right, let's go back to Billy.
That will cost Raftery a quick sawbuck.
I'm glad my wife's in the building. Bruce gets all the luck, doesn't he?
Oh, yeah, he does. That's it. The exchange was just made between Beck and Raftery, a quick 10. I like it. 11.5 to play. Dowdell's in the game now, wearing number 22 for Temple. Freddie Banks goes over the top. Jerome Dowdell missed the entire 84-85 season because of surgery on his left Achilles tendon. He's a junior from Atlanta, Georgia, 6'3 guard. This is Perry now and Blackwell.
That cross-court pass, Howard, was the first time that Vegas has done it all evening, and they worked on it. Because, unfortunately, Freddie Banks unable to convert.
Watching Evans patrolling the baseline. Now they're going essentially with three guards. This is Dowdell, the new man of the game. He's a good shooter. Hasn't had too much of an opportunity. Evans, good penetration. And Perry with a good rebound. Ooh, that should have been goaltending, I think. Here's Perry, gets it right in his face. And he's going to get two out of it.
Give it to Robinson or Gilliam. But Temple, smelling a little bit, a little more aggressive. Banging.
Robinson gets the foul.
This is the flyer that you mentioned. I wonder if Evans did that. It was Philly, huh? And here you see, I thought that should have been goaltending as you did, and Robinson gets a couple of dollars out of this one.
Well, Tim Perry will go to the line, but Howard Evans, who played high school ball at West Philly under Joey Goldenberg. Goldenberg, by the way, a Temple grad, very successful high school coach in West Philadelphia.
Jimmy Perry pursuing very well. But if anything, you know, people sitting home watching the ball game saying, gee, why isn't Vegas running? It's more Temple stopping it.
Absolutely.
Getting back in their set, balancing the floor, and then, of course, the zone.
Now they're trying to free up Freddie Banks for the outside jumper. The running Rebels are going with three guards to match up with Temple's three guards.
You can see Dowell running through, following him on that baseline.
Banks.
A force, and it's good.
58-51, a seven-point game. That is the third three-point field goal by Freddie Banks. He now has 15 points, 10 in the second half.
So it's the big thing for Temple is they've got these two people that just had the ball. Blackwell and Evans, they've been there. They can control it.
Dowdell in the left corner finds Blackwell, and good turnover created by Wade. Here comes Banks ahead of the pack with body control, and a pretty move by Freddie Banks.
Acrobatic, hanging long enough, looking for a foul.
Even the Russian judge gave him a 9-5.
Oh, this is something. Trying to go over Rivas. He knows somebody's behind him. Evans, in his case, and able to convert.
A five-point game. The running Rebels are running now. Dowdell off the mark. Rebound Robinson, and Nevada Las Vegas is back in the game.
You'll see Rieswick shortly, I think. I don't think they wanted Dow to take that shot.
Pretty pass to Gilliam from Banks. Doesn't go. A tip in by Graham. Robinson or Graham.
I give it to Graham. I would.
58-55. The running Rebels have put on seven unanswered points in a row. 9:09 remaining. And it's Freddie Banks. They said he had to be the catalyst. He has been just that. He's making some things happen. And it's getting infectious. Blackwell now taking the game into his hands. Rivas over the top on Gilliam is going to be called for the foul. And the tide now starting to swing as Mike Griswick, as you said, comes back into the ball game.
Well, we gave this last one to Graham. Robinson there with those long arms. You'll see Gary Graham sneak in here. I thought he got it. Not so sure who they gave it to.
8:50 remaining in the game, and Temple's lead has shrunk to three. It once was 12.
Now, Nate Blackwell forced that one. That's not what John Chaney would like. Those good clubs make runs, and the team that's going to win reacts to it. Look at everybody in red on the glass.
Freddie Banks, the smallest man in the group, comes up with the basket, and it's a one-point game.
First Temple with four timeouts. John Chaney, good look here by Blackwell.
Evans off the glass.
John Chaney patient because of the guards, I'm sure.
60-57, Temple by three. This is more of a Vegas kind of game. Banks throws up the haymaker, and Graham gets fouled by Howard Evans coming around.
Plus, right now, if you're Temple, you want your guards controlling the show, and Blackwell with a gamble, as upperclassmen and experienced people will do. Good hanging basket and a kiss by Evans.
Evans, second team All-Atlantic 10 preseason. Running Rebels of Nevada Las Vegas within three. Inside to Gilliam, and Rivas, I think, is going to be hit for his fourth personal foul.
Got there late, but you mentioned before the three guards, a little more mobility for Vegas. They've got some action, some motion on their offense, able to get free.
We have 7:56 remaining. Temple leads by three. Second half points. Nate Blackwell has been shut down entirely in the second half for Temple.
Adjustments. Halftime, of course, those girls waiting for Larry Finch in Memphis State. They get themselves prepared mentally and physically. But Vegas not asleep this half.
No, they are not. They have turned it on in the second half. Nevada Las Vegas has outscored Temple in the second half, 24-20. And they have cut a seven-point halftime lead to three, and it is Rebel ball. Mark Wade, who has been scoreless thus far. Graham. They kick it inside. Gilliam.
What they've done is force Temple more man-to-man matching up.
Gilliam gets away. Result is it's a one-point game. All-court pressure again by the running Rebels.
This is where you want composure. And, of course, Temple used to this guy who struggled a little bit in the backcourt with the dribble. Nate Blackwell to make sure they remain composed.
Blackwell was Cheney's first recruit when he came to Temple University. Griswick. Go with what brung you here, right?
That's right.
63-59, Temple's lead is four. That is the fifth three-point field goal from Mike Breeswick.
A little rest does the soul good.
He has 20 points. Graham, a little bit of a stutter step, took too many.
The hop.
Well, we'll see if Temple, which if they can withstand the run by the running Rebels of Nevada, Las Vegas. At one point, it was a 12-point game with 15:57 to go in this half. And then in the last 6 minutes or so, Nevada, Las Vegas made a run at them. They cut that lead by outscoring Temple 21-10 in the last 6 minutes.
Well, Breeswick may force Tarkanian to play Gerald Patio, because if he starts lighting it up and Graham can't guard him, good play.
Blackwell had room to shoot on a nice pass by Evans. Robinson with a rebound. Here's Wade now in transition. Finding Freddie Banks. Three-point range.
Set play, really. He was the trailer sliding deep. And, of course, Mark Wade knows where his partner is.
Banks with 22 points, 17 in his half, and a timeout. Somebody got, I don't know, either hit in the face or poked in the... Who's Brantley, who's doubled over. He appears to be all right.
Temple was pointing at Gilliam.
Blackwell has been shut down. He is 0 for 6 in this half from the floor. As you suggested, Patio comes back into the ball game. Jarvis Bassnight, who has 4 fouls, also comes back.
It goes for you one way, now you got to stop them the other. That forced that sub. Breeswick able to make the long one.
A 1-point game, and Blackwell is having his problems in this half. Mark Wade said, yes, I had a steal, and... That's the third foul on Wade. I love what he did.
Don't you love the emotion?
Yeah, Sam Licklider, the referee, making the call. Mark Wade said, nah, Sam, I don't agree with you, but you are the boss.
Pretty clever move defensively.
So Nate Blackwell will go to the line. Preseason first team All-Atlantic 10. Probably by season's end, he will finish second all-time in Temple history for career assists behind Rick Reed. I think Reed's got too much of a lead on him for him to catch him, but he definitely would be second in the all-time list. 65-62. Temple in front with 6:05 remaining in the game.
Breeswick is forking Freddie Banks.
Gilliam, who has been really quiet for the most part. Patio puts up a three-pointer. Gilliam is not quiet there.
They've really spread them out with hard cutting. And here's another Temple player down.
Howard Evans, I believe. Or I believe it. Is it Howard Evans? Perhaps?
Yes. That's who it is.
It is Evans.
He must have run under where he didn't belong. That's the land of the Giants.
Tried to go through the tunnel and didn't have the exact change. John Chaney in his fifth year at Temple University. Atlantic 10 Coach of the Year twice.
Of course, Charlie Diokas, the athletic director at Temple, has been raving to me about the job John Chaney does. And of course, tonight, they come in ready, prepared. Tough basketball team. Yeah, they want to take them out just so they can save the timeout.
They're calling, I think they're going to charge Temple. They have to charge Temple with a timeout.
Well, if they take him out, it's okay.
Oh, I see.
So, John Chaney doesn't want him out.
Yeah, he wants him in the game. He's one of the reasons why Temple leads, but he has shrunk to a single point with 5:48 remaining in the second half of the semifinal game. Coming up later, Western Kentucky and Memphis State.
Workout was Vegas, their drills. And man-to-man. I mean, they go after it. For the time allotted on the floor, they look in great shape. They're tenacious. I thought they were soft inside defensively. And, of course, you get softer when you can't score. And they were struggling against this Temple zone.
Freddie Banks has 17 of those points in this half. Armand Gilliam has 15 points. And while I think he's an outstanding player, that's the quietest 15.
Yeah, exactly. 11 in the first half, that surprised me.
Evans, three-point range. Doesn't go. Tap by Wade. That set it all off. A three-on-one. Gilliam, excellent defense by Howard Evans to bust up a three-on-one fast break.
I thought it was given up too early. Gave Evans a chance to slide over. And then the anxious Temple people unable to get their hands. Too many hands on it.
Fastnight triggers the inbound. This is Wade. With 5:24 to play.
See how early it's given up, gives Evans all that time and opportunity. All ball.
The smaller guard went after the big man right away. You talk about going after it. Traveling violation against Gerald Patio.
They've had three of those where they start running before they put the ball down.
10 turnovers against Nevada Las Vegas. And 7 for Temple. Ramon Rivas comes back into the ballgame. 5:10 remaining. Temple in front by a point.
Little trap.
They led by as many as 12 at one point.
Blackwell saved. Evans come to the ball, but he hit a soft pass. Got a snap back.
And Rieswick leading Temple, excuse me, with 20 points.
And he's got to be alert, too, as the small forward. If they run this trap, he's got to bail out the guards.
The alley-oop inside to Perry and a pretty pass, and he just threw it up.
This should be Rieswick.
And Rieswick gets called for the personal foul. Pass is good inside, and Perry really didn't take his time to look.
Pretty look, wasn't it? Guards will find you with this Temple team. Of course, gathered himself, and just a slight tick of the ball by Armin Gilliam.
Credit Gilliam.
Yeah, he did. Got
with
a piece
the intimidation. And a piece of the ball as well. So Nevada Las Vegas can take the lead for the first time in the game.
Following the wings through.
Banks, he's got it, gotten it going for Nevada Las Vegas in this half. Wade doesn't get the roll, but Patio comes up with it.
Nice pass.
Fastnight, strong move to the basket. And Nevada Las Vegas takes the lead for the first time.
Without the dribble, good trap. Almost come up with it, but Banks was out of bounds.
So with 4:13 to go in the game, Nevada Las Vegas, who's trailed all night, takes the lead, 66-65.
Push.
Foul from
Patio.
The backside, Gerald Patio. Patio commits his second, and Nevada Las Vegas is over the limit. So this will be a one-on-one opportunity for Temple.
Now, Temple has everybody down to get the basketball in. Their main concern is getting it in. But what that does, if your people don't vacate, it keeps a lot of help and trapping people in the area. And, of course, Vegas almost came up with one. Only Freddie Banks happened to be out of bounds.
Rieswick had a big night, 21 points. And he had Rolly Massimino scratching his head the other night. He's Rieswick reminds me a lot of a right-handed Chris Mullin. A little bit of a gym rat, hangs out in the gym a lot. Excellent shooter.
Vegas now countering with that lineup that you like. Gary Graham in for Gerald Patio.
Temple regains the lead by one with 4:05 remaining.
This is a real man-to-man look.
This is Graham now. It's Wade.
It is the matchup. Good look.
Good play by Gilliam to keep it alive. He gets the kickback from Graham.
They really are overloading and confusing Temple, getting much easier shots this second half. Some great adjustments at the half.
Third lead change and as many trips down the floor. 3:34 remaining.
They're really bellying up on Rieswick, aren't they?
Well, they put the best defensive man, Graham, on Rieswick to try to slow him down a little bit. Nobody else has been able to do it. Evans, soft jumper.
Nice, that he pushed it ahead just a little bit so Mark Wade couldn't get a hand on the ball.
Fourth lead change in as many trips down the floor with 3:04 remaining. Temple leads by one. Gilliam, too hard. And Rieswick with the rebound.
They've stopped doing that. Helping out, little guys going down.
Rieswick against Virginia, played 7 minutes, had 6 points, played 24 minutes against Villanova, had 19.
Good looking play by Nate Blackwell. Coach Tim Curry, the recipient, pretty good hands to come down with it.
Last night is through. That
is that
was
it?
Fifth
the
foul.
Fifth one? You'll see the penetration. This is what he does beautifully. Shows you that left side, spins back, and look at the dump off the jumper. Some kids will say, I didn't see you. Tim Curry fouled, causing that air ball.
So Jarvis Bass Knight has had a night. He is all through for tonight. Finishes the game with 6 points and fouls out Tim Perry with a dozen thus far. Perry's father, Lee Perry Sr., was a baseball, football, and track star at Freehold High School, where Tim went to school. It's only a junior.
Temple without anybody underneath. They don't want any over-the-top fouls.
70-68 as Gerald Patio comes back into the game. Graham goes to the bench with 2:43 remaining. Temple in front by two. They led by 12. Nevada, Las Vegas put on a heck of a spurt, took the lead momentarily. And Temple now ups the lead to three.
Showing some mettle.
Yes.
Right? Getting behind, coming back.
I asked Barkanian before the game if he favored a game in the 80s. He said, just want to win at the primary. Brieswick wrestling with his own teammate.
Oh,
this kid wants to, he has come to play some basketball. Keep in mind, he grew up in Morrisville, Pennsylvania. That's about an hour and 20 minutes from Madison Square Garden, so he's heard of this place.
Good trap, turns it over, should be on Evans.
It's going to be on Evans. Howard Evans commits the foul. That is his third.
What he did, he didn't fake. He threw the ball into the man's hand. Should have faked and gone under. But right here, the big guy, 6'10". Robinson, you see the shove? Easy call. Richard Robinson with that big frame.
2:15 remaining. Temple leading the third-ranked running Rebels from Nevada, Las Vegas by 3 points. Brieswick right up in Banks' face will not give him the three-point territory. Patio from three-point range ties it up.
When he's set and doesn't rush it, he's got a nice-looking stroke, and the form is perfect.
Minute and 53 remaining. We are tied at 71.
Trap again.
That is the fifth three-pointer by Gerald Patio. Blackwell, who's been cold in this half.
What hustle by Rivas.
Good hustle also by Gilliam. And it is Nevada Las Vegas' ball with a minute and 34 to go, and we are tied at 71. To say the tempo has picked up emotionally would be an understatement.
All set.
Patio's hot. Three-point lead.
Temple was not alert. They were not communicating. Didn't match up properly.
With 1:20 to go. Nevada Las Vegas leading 74-71. Blackwell, who has been ice cold in this half, he has 3 points in that, 2 points in the half. Brieswick puts it up as he was fouled.
Good call, too.
By Gerald Patio.
You can see the leg. One thing Vegas does in a terrific fashion is stretch that leg to try and regain the position. Most players use the hands or the arms. Gerald Patio just couldn't get there in time.
So Mike Brieswick will go to the line. With a one-and-one opportunity, since Nevada Las Vegas is over the limit, Temple is at the limit with six.
He wants two.
Brieswick wants two.
The way he shoots, 87, he should get two.
It should be, it's almost automatic the way he shoots. 74-72, Nevada Las Vegas.
Wait, Howie!
And it is a one-point game. Timeout called for. Second half of this doubleheader will have the Tigers of Memphis State against the Hilltoppers of Western Kentucky. The winner of that game to play the winner of this game tomorrow night. And we'll have it for you, beginning with airtime at 9 o'clock from Madison Square Garden in New York. Of course, that's Eastern time. Howard David and Bill Raftery, along with Bruce Beck.
Of course, the timeout now, Temple's got to be concerned what the Tark does. And of course, the Tark's got to make a decision. Should I run it down a little bit? Which would get them out of the type of pace and pattern that they would like to run. But it gives John Chaney an opportunity to go over.
74-73, and it wasn't too long ago that Temple had a 12-point lead. Freddie Banks got everything going for the running Rebels, and he has really put it together in the second half. He has 17 second-half points.
Now, the one thing Temple does is they extend the 1-3-1 and trap out of it. We'll see what they come out with. And they call a timeout, Vegas, because Temple was in that set, 1-3-1.
Battle Las Vegas has two timeouts remaining, likewise Temple. And I was looking over in the Battle Las Vegas's schedule, and just to the right of your screen, the guy with the blue shirt and the gray hair is Charlie Fiokas, who's the athletic director. Getting into the flow of college basketball is back. And I know you have your love for college hoops, mine the same, and you get back into the flow. It's all over again. It's all starting all over again. It's hard to believe that we still have 4 months to go before March comes around.
And high-pitched at this point in the year. Admiration for Freddie Banks, high coming in. He did not have a good first half, didn't sulk, didn't back off from the opportunity, showed itself. Excellent second half. Here's the full court pressure now by Temple.
Minute and six to play. Nevada, Las Vegas with the ball and the lead. 74-73.
2-2-1.
Gilliam looking for somebody, now finds Wade. Patio over Rebus.
Bad shot and they get a break.
We'd like to welcome station WMKW in Memphis, Tennessee, and WBKO in Bowling Green, Kentucky, joining us in the late stages of this first semifinal game between Nevada, Las Vegas and Temple. The score is Nevada, Las Vegas leading Temple 74-73. That's the second half of our doubleheader. And the Memphis State Tigers meeting the Western Kentucky Hilltoppers. They have 52 seconds to play. Gilliam gives Nevada, Las Vegas a two-point lead.
And 60% shooter off of two games with Gerald Patio with a ill-advised shot. And Vegas hitting the glass strong. I think they gave that foul to Tim Perry.
It's a big free throw here. It is a two-point game with 50 seconds remaining. Now, if you're Temple, you obviously can go all the way down with the shot clock if you want to, or do you try to put it up right away?
I think they'll look for a good one early, particularly with these two guards able to penetrate, and Vrizik with that long-range ability.
This is Vrizik here. He has been on fire. Blackwell from three-point range. Vrizik looking for the tip. He follows it up. He misses it. And it is Nevada Las Vegas ball. Long lead pass. Recovered by Perry of Temple with 17 seconds to play. Temple trailing by two. Vegas up by two with a dozen seconds.
And one.
Evans basket counts and he's fouled. We are tied with 10 seconds remaining. Howard Evans with a big bucket. And we are tied at 75.
Tell you, wild. It's all set up by a long pass. Evans forcing the issue here with a little dipsy do. The spin, the lean. Great follow through, and Mark Wade underneath, they're giving him the bump, but the long pass costs Vegas, ill-advised as well as the shot earlier.
Evans can put him in front, and he does. 76-75, Temple in front with 10 seconds remaining. Jerry Tarkanian now has the ball, his team does, with 10 seconds to play. That's plenty of time to bring it up.
Plenty is right. Of course, the timeout, according to the officials, was Temple. So John Chaney wants to set up what Vegas may run late in the game historically, because there's only two games this year to go by, and of course set their pressure up.
What's interesting is that all four teams here tonight are all even. They're all 2-0. They all started out in the Big Apple, Coca-Cola NIT. John Chaney and his Temple team, preseason choice to win the Atlantic 10.
Did you see Vrizik go after
underneath,
the rebound underneath? Oh, aggressive. He wanted it. Of course, it bounced out to the corner, and I'm not so sure who threw the ball down the floor. I thought it
Wade.
Was it Wade? Okay.
Wade with a left-handed pass.
Yeah, that's
pass.
Right. All right, now Patio makes the save deep. Right here, not a good pass.
There's Wade's pass.
We've got 10 seconds in the backcourt. You can take all the time you want.
And let him foul you.
I thought it may have been out of bounds. Patio makes a great save. And, of course, that sets up the sequence. Tim Perry running the basketball down. And, boy, when you have guards that have been there before, here's the junior, Howard Evans, the little lean-in. He wanted it all the way. And, of course, Mark Wade saying, I didn't touch him. Plenty of room there, too. Tough call against Vegas.
6 seconds with five. Gilliam with three to the baseline. They may not get the shot off. It's down.
Scored the the goal. I think it was Gerald Patio.
Nevada, Las Vegas, and a dramatic win. 78-76, the basket counts. I thought it was a three-pointer.
You're right.
It doesn't matter if it's three or two, it's still game time. It's either a one-point game or a two-point game.
What a tough loss for John Chaney.
Tremendous basketball, and this is only November 28th. Oh, man, what a shot. With 1 second to go, he let it go. The buzzer went off, the basket went in. Here it is. Patio.
Oh, all net. Look at him. That's as high as he's been up all night.
Gerald Patio with the winning basket at the buzzer. Nevada, Las Vegas comes away with a 78.